and welcome to part three of our three-part series on connecting Xero or Postman to Xero with Auth2. My name is Matt, I'm part of the API team, and we're going to be looking through steps 7, 8, and 9 of connecting of making API calls. So in this one, we're going to be calling the connections endpoint, invoices endpoint, and making a refresh call. Now, we'll actually probably start off with refresh token, even though it is step number 9. If you've walked away for a while and you no longer have you've extended over your 30-minute access time with your access token, you just want to come in here and use the refresh token call to refresh your access and refresh tokens. So there we go. It's as simple as that. We've already done all the hard work for you. Literally, you just have to come in here, click post and send, and you should be able to refresh your access token. If you do get anything else like a invalid grant, you may be using a older refresh token. So if you do get any errors inside of here, you will just have to go to get started, authorization, and get new access token again, and then just go through the authorization process one more time. You'll then be given a new access and refresh token. Just be sure to refresh those once you've set them again, as in part three of the tutorial. Oh, sorry, part two of the tutorial beforehand. We're good to go. I've just been given a new access and refresh token, so I've got 30 minutes worth of access to my organizations. Let's call the connections endpoint. Now, the connections endpoint is basically a list of organizations your app currently has access to. Now, you'll get these five bits of elements right here. So, first one, ID, which is really your connection ID. That can be used to remove the connection from your end. So as an example, is if I change that to delete and then add /ID onto the end of that, I could use that call to delete this organization. Not delete the organization, just the connection to that organization. I'm not going to do that right now because I need it, but that's what you do with that. Tenant ID, now that is of course the unique identifier for your organization in question. It can also sometimes be called organization ID. However, we've just labeled it tenant ID in here. So if you hear that as organization ID anywhere else, that's what that is as well. This is actually what lets your calls talk directly to an organization. So as an example, up in here, you can see we've got 0 tenant ID of nothing and null. Because of that, we don't know who we're actually speaking to at the moment. It's basically like having all of the bits of a letter written down on the envelope and just not having the house address written on there. Okay, so all we're going to do is make that connection call, come up to your environment once you've made it, and plop the tenant ID into both of these fields. So I've updated that. Fantastic. And then just on these last three elements as well, tenant ID, just organization. We only have organizations at the moment. However, at a later date, there may be Xero HQ or other tenants as well, and then the updated and created date as well, UTC. Created date will be the initial connection, so you can see I made it today, and then the updated date will actually be as if the organization was disconnected from your app, and then the date it was reconnected. So if I disconnected today and then reconnected in 2 days' time on the 20th, this updated date will then show as the 20th. Right, fantastic. So now that I've got my tenant ID up in there, we can come across to get invoices and make an invoice call. Now, fantastic, there we go. That was successful, 200 okay. There's my invoice number 1 for Bob. That's basically it, in all honesty. Now, I'll just show you what happens if you don't include the tenant ID. If I send that off instead, 403, I don't know who you're trying to talk to. The authentication is unsuccessful. I'm not going to let the call through. Okay, it's as simple as that. If you don't instead include the access token, which is actually it's your access token right there telling you exactly what it's allowed to access. If I send that off instead, there we go. Consumer key unknown. I don't know your consumer key. It wasn't recognized. I'm not going to let your call through. Simple as that. Other little handy tips and tricks. We do have a couple test scripts and scripts actually added to these calls for you. As an example, this pre-request script, anytime you're making a call with the invoices call, it will actually refresh your token for you. That's just a little handy thing that we decided to add in there. The refresh token as well, a similar thing where the test will, or the test script here will automatically shove the access token and refresh token up into the environment for you. And then the connections endpoint also has a similar one with the Xero tenant ID. Now, if you do run the get connections endpoint again, after you've maybe connected a second or third organization, just be careful. Oh, something went wrong. Why did that go wrong? Connection ID was not connection ID. Oh, because I'm trying to delete it. That's why. Let's change that to a get. And we go back to here and just go send. There we go. That's all right. What it can do is if you make a call to the connections endpoint, it can actually strip out your Xero tenant ID. So if you are now coming along and expecting this to work and go, oh, cool, why am I getting a 403? Just check your environment for your tenant ID. If it's not there, just come back to your connections and copy your tenant ID out again. Oops. There we go. Okie dokie. If anyone has any questions or would like to get in contact around with us around Postman and OAuth2 and Xero or any of the API questions, really, please feel free to email us at api@xero.com or head over to the Xero Central website at central.xero.com and raise a case with us there. And we'll be more than happy to help you out. Happy APIing and have a good one. Bye.